Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me tell you about the Webcam Settings app. So the Webcam Settings app is so useful and so basic you think it would come with your Mac, but it doesn't. You have to search for it in the Mac App Store. Just search for Webcam Settings and it comes up right away. You can see it right here. The regular price is $7.99. It's from a third-party developer. If you search, you'll find a lot of video podcasters and Mac users talking about this app. So it's getting very popular. And if you look at the listing here in the Mac App Store, you'll see some good reviews and a lot of information about it. So once you get it, then you can run it from Launchpad. I've got it right here. And once you run it, it appears here at the top of the screen as an icon, and you can access the settings by going to Show Webcam Settings panel. Now the settings panel is particularly useful if you have a third-party camera. Like I've got the C920, the Logitech webcam, since I have a Mac Pro that doesn't have a camera built in. But it also works with the FaceTime cameras built into Macs, like say on my MacBook Pro, works with that. And it gives you a whole set of controls over here where you can manually control all sorts of things like brightness and contrast and saturation. The settings that you see will depend upon which camera you've got. So you're going to see a different set of settings and some that will be active or won't be active based on the webcam that you're using. Now you've got some basic things here. The advanced things really give you a lot of control, like for instance the ability to zoom in. Now of course if your webcam doesn't have lenses in it, which it probably doesn't, or at least not lenses that can focus, you won't really be able to zoom, but it will use pixels to zoom. So for instance this webcam is a 1080p webcam, so being able to zoom in and have a lower resolution image but using a portion of it is very useful. Then you can also pan and tilt. Pan is very useful if you've zoomed in a little bit. You'll be able to pan from left to right. And I use these controls all the time. And you can also save profiles. So once you've set things up just like you want, you can save a profile and then quickly get to it. It's very useful when there's some separate lighting and things in different situations and you want to set it up and quickly access those controls. So here I'm actually going to use the controls live. So you're seeing me as usually would when I record the beginning of the video. But I've brought up the control panel here and I can adjust things. So I can adjust brightness here of the camera, the contrast, and things like saturation, desaturate, sharpness. I've got white balance controls that I can move around or set it to automatic. So there's a lot I could do here. I could also have autofocus turned off and I could change the focus directly so I can manually control the focus of the camera, which is very useful. I've zoomed in a little bit here and panned over so I can actually zoom back out. You can see a little bit of the background appear there and I can change the pan since I've zoomed things in. So there's a lot of different things that I could do. Here it's just an example of just working with the settings live. So when I was just using QuickTime player to record that video, since that's what works with my camera, but it should work with recording no matter what software you're using. If the software uses that webcam, then webcam settings would be adjusting the settings of the camera itself. So give it a look. I'll put a link to it in the notes for this video at MacMost.com. Thanks.